connecting with nature, with love and devotion, a trusting companion, built high on emotion, a good horse and rider, patiently trained.
In 1926, Purina established this working farm in Gray Summit, Missouri, to support product development and feed trials. Today it's known as the Purina Animal Nutrition Center. This season of riding horses, we've got a four-year-old granddaughter, Playgun, that was born and raised there, that we're going to use to give you an in-depth, week-to-week look at our approach with our horses. Her name is Holly Seven Petals. We call her Miss Purina. Purina has been the number one reason our horses have stayed healthy and sound over the last 10 years. So for me to have this opportunity to use one of the horses that they've had at their farm for research is pretty special to me. So join us as we introduce Miss Purina to this new chapter in her life and let you see her transformation through our program. Our horses work hard for us every day, so nutrition is a major concern. I've relied on Purina horse feed products for over 12 years. Purina is always on the leading edge of research and nutrition innovation, and with their feed guard system, I know I can rely on the safety and quality of their products from coast to coast. No matter what you do with your horse, Purina has the right product for you. Visit horse.purinamills.com or find them on Facebook for more information. Good morning, everybody. Welcome to this week's episode of Riding Horses. It's a little brisk morning out here this morning. The wind's blowing pretty good and it's a little bit chilly. So I guess really what I'm saying is I'm going to have to work to put a smile on my face, but praise the Lord, I'm out here on my horse and even have the opportunity to get out here today to ride some. Today I'm going to start to introduce the idea of being a little bit more specific about what lead my horse lopes off on. Up till this point, I really haven't tried to be very specific with this mare. I've just been trying to get her to where she'd roll up into that lope and not fight me. I've been working on trying to roll her up in my hand some while I'm asking her to transition up to the lope. But as far as asking her which lead to be in, I haven't been very specific. There's been some little things that I've done just to help out along the way while we were filming, but for the most part, I haven't spent a lot of time working on control of this horse's hip to set up for that lead departure. So I want to kind of break it down today and give you guys an idea of what I'm looking for and what I'm the most concerned about. Now this mare, she looks pretty quiet right now, but I haven't warmed her up at all. All we did was put the saddle on her and I crawled on. And I did that because once I get to moving her around and start pushing around on this hip, with her being fresh, I think she's gonna show a little bit more, not just expression, but I think she's gonna resist me a little bit more. I want her head to come up and I want you guys to see some places where she might be fighting me in my hands, just so maybe you could better relate to it at home. So I'm just gonna kind of play it by ear with what she brings up. But really all I'm gonna be asking for is just a simple step today, getting this mare to move her hip either to the right or to the left. And if I think about what I'm really asking for, I'm just asking for my horse to move their hip over enough, possibly just so they'd be two tracking. So if I'm walking straight at the camera, this horse is laying down two sets of tracks. The hindquarters aren't lined up directly behind the front end, which they'd be traveling then on just the same set of tracks. So as we go around here, that's really all I'm going to be asking for. Again, I haven't put spurs on yet with this mare, but I do have my dressage whip, and I'm still playing around here. I'm still trying to figure out how far I can get this mare before I feel like I need to put those spurs on. And so far, she's staying really, really soft, and she's showing a lot of respect to my legs. But again, I'm using this dressage whip to reinforce that. Now, before I get to pushing around on her here, one more thing I want to share with you guys. My lead departure, for me, the way I look at it, and the way I've struggled so much with my lead departures in the past, to me, or not just my lead departures, but more of my lead changes, my lead departure is basically leading me into that lead change. And what more people struggle with than anything when they start working on lead changes is their horses tend to get faster and faster and faster. So today I'm going to keep everything slow, and I'm going to talk you guys through the process that I'm thinking about building in this mare before I put a lot of pressure on her, how I can start to address some of the things that start to come up in my horse when I start to ask this hindquarters to move right or left. So I'm just going to get her moving around here for a minute. Just pick up on her a little bit, see where she's at, see if she's listening to me. I'm gonna roll her up to a trot here just a little bit. If I think about what I do with my legs, I'll bring her back to a walk. What I do with my legs to bring her up to a trot, guys, is I'm squeezing with both legs to roll this horse up to a trot. Okay, so this horse starts to, and we've talked about this before, my horse starts to relate that squeeze with more life. Well, if I think about what's gonna happen when I start asking my horse to move their hip over, I'm squeezing, but I'm only squeezing with one leg. And sometimes it takes our horses a while to figure out that when we squeeze with one leg, it means move over, doesn't mean speed up. So probably the simplest way for me to start this process, now here in the round pen today, I'm going to use this fence some. Probably the easiest place to start for most people, if they're dealing with a horse that's not used to moving off their leg and moving their hip over, or maybe somebody's been riding that horse and never even thought to go that far, they've just been trail riding on that horse. My fence can really help me to the point of, as I get close to the fence, if I tip my horse's nose to the fence, it makes it really easy to swing that hip over there. Coming off the fence here, coming at the camera. If I tip this nose, mare's nose slightly to the left, what I'm doing with my, I'll move it here just so you can see. What I'm doing with my left foot specifically is I'm right back here by my back cinch. Okay, I'm gonna start to make a really big deal out of this position on my horse, and I'm gonna call that position 3. Now, if I wanna stay on that fence, or I feel like I need to stay on that fence because as I come back here and I start to push position 3, my horse really wants to speed up. Well, if I come back over there to the fence, as I tip that horse's nose into the fence, if I can get that hip to move over, as long as I keep her nose tipped to the fence, it's really hard for her to go trot off right there in that position, unless she's gonna trot off either in a side pass or at a diagonal, because I've got her nose tipped to the fence. So I'm using my fence to some extent to block some of that forward that my horse might throw at me. I don't want to block all of it, but I might need that fence for a little bit if my horse, when I go to pushing back here, really wants to push into my hands and just speed up. Here, coming at the camera again, I'm gonna tip her nose slightly to the right. My right foot is back here in position 3. And all I'm asking that hip to do is step over there. Okay, now, for a while, I mean, this is pretty slow, but if you guys watch close enough on that camera, you can see this mare at times already start to work her mouth a little bit on this bit. Okay, what I'm trying to think of, I can push a horse through this pretty fast, and I can really get one's hip to move and not put much thought into the frame of mind that my horse has. But really what I'm thinking about more than anything is how relaxed could I get my horse to be while I'm playing around here moving their hip to where they don't get nervous. That's probably the thing that gets a horse the most. And me personally, I think it's because those horses get stuck on the fact that when we go to pushing with just one foot back here, right in front of that back cinch in position three, and we ask that hip to step over, I think those horses, majority of the time, they're thinking about speeding up, moving off that squeeze like we've taught them. When I do this, speed up, kind of dead right there. So it's not understandable where it might come from. But if that's what my horse is thinking, and then I just go to pulling on them with my reins to try to slow that down, and all I'm concerned about is the feet. I'm not concerned about my horse's frame of mind at all. I'm not really concerned about what it feels like in my hand, how hard I've got to pull on him. All I'm concerned about is whether or not I can get him to two track. It seems like it takes forever to get those horses to relax to where you could go out there and do a simple lead change and it not be something that ends up with a lot of extra speed that you didn't really ask for. You know, we say in the beginning, if we go back to first three rides on this mare, I would bring her nose way over here and ask that hip to move over. Okay, so I've started the process clear back there when I was doing this. I bring her nose all the way here, almost to my right toe, and I'm pushing here in position three, right in front of that back cinch. I want to feel that horse's hip step over. Now, down the road, we're going to work on this for the next couple weeks, because I think you're going to see a lot of change in this horse over the next couple weeks, and we can continue to add to what I'm talking about this morning. But down the road, we're going to get to a spot where I'm going to tip her nose to the left, but I'm going to ask her hip to come to the left at the same time. For now, we're still at this spot where we're making use of what we started with in the beginning, even though over there on the fence, I tip her nose to the fence. Here I'm off the fence and I'm bringing her nose way around here, but I want this mare to put some effort into moving that hip off my foot. And here's the fun part, guys. Again, to me, it's going back to not only how soft I can get my horse, but can I get my horse in a frame of mind where they're thinking about carrying some life? And that's kind of where I'm at out here trying to do this without any spurs on. Just a little step right there. Just gonna back her up here and give me a little bit more room between me and the camera. Coming at the camera this way. I'm gonna tip her nose slightly to the left, push position three. I might help there a little bit, get just a little bit more step there when I encourage just a little bit with this. Basically, that dressage whip is gonna act as my spur. So if I think about that two track, guys, I'm talking simple. And I'm saying I need to work at this so slow that my horse can start to understand the concept of what I'm after, not get confused with, okay, he's squeezing with the leg, so I'm supposed to speed up. To where as we start to add speed, my horse isn't just fighting me or getting so nervous that she can't hardly control herself. Actually, she gets to where she can't relax. And then next thing you know, if I ever have to do a lead change and leave my hand down here, I don't take the slack out of the reins to hold her. When I ask for that lead change, she's gone. So we're gonna keep it simple today. I think that'll get you guys started. I'll talk a little bit more. We're gonna take a short break here so I can warm up a little bit. But when we come back, I'll talk a little bit more about exactly the step that I want in that two track that's going to lead us into that lead departure. So stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Riding horses each day is a horse lover's dream.
With all the hauling and training we do each year, we put a lot of stress on our horses. Since adding Forco to our feeding program to help maintain the digestive system, our horses have never looked better, acted better, or performed as well as they do now. We are very excited to be bringing on board Lisa's Western Wear in Pratt, Kansas, as a new team member here at Kerry Kuhn Horsemanship. Lisa's Western Wear has the latest in Western fashions for men and women. They have a great selection of jeans, shirts, boots, hats, children's apparel, jewelry, Western style home decor, as well as a full line of ropes and tack. They also carry the snaffle and transition bits that we use in our program that we feel are so important in building that proper foundation. So if you're looking for something Western, check them out at leaseswesternwear.com, or if you're in the area, be sure to stop in and see them. All right, guys, welcome back. Sorry, we're out here delirious because it's so cold. I'm just trying to warm up. All right, we're talking about moving this horse's hindquarters a little bit and getting her to two-track. My idea in that two-track, if I think about my lead and how it starts and where I want my horse to focus, when I ask my horse to lope off in the right lead, the first step is the left hind foot. And it takes, I mean, about the best way for me to describe it so it's easy to comprehend, let's say that left hind foot takes a half a step. The next step is the right hind and the left front. They go together. But if I just focus on the right hind, that left hind is going to take a half a step, and I'm going to say the right hind is going to take a full step. Okay? So if I look at it that way, the left foot's not reaching near as far forward as the right foot. The right lead, left lead, they've got three beats. So it's left hind first, right hind, left front second, right front third. But then I can break it up and say this. The left hind is taking a half a step. The right hind's taking a full step. But the left front is going with the right hind. And to me, the left front takes a half a step as well. When I watch a horse lope, the way I look at it, to me, it looks like both legs on the right side reach farther forward if my horse is in the right lead, then both legs on the left side. But what I'm trying to get my horse to focus on primarily is their hindquarters, okay? I spent too much time growing up trying to figure out how to make a 90-degree turn while I'm loping to get my horse to change leads, and the problem was I could only get him to switch in the front. I couldn't get him to switch in the back. But it was my fault because I wasn't encouraging my horse to focus back here and focus on making that switch first in the back. I was thinking I could switch him in the front and the back would follow. That's not always the case. So I'm thinking about, as I ask my horse to make this two-step or two-step, do you think I'm out here dancing? Well, I guess I kind of am. I meant to say two-track. As I think about that two-track and I ask that horse's hip to step over there, if you watch this horse's hind feet, let's think of it as a lateral move too, just so you guys can comprehend it a little bit easier. Instead of me just going in a straight line, think of it as a lateral move. So my horse's hind feet are like this. If it's a lateral move, then this foot, if I'm asking for the right lead, the left hind foot's not going to reach very far because this one's in the way. So it's going to come here. It might come in front. I don't even know that I want it to necessarily come clear in front, but it's going to come over a little bit, and then this one has the freedom because there's nothing in the way over here. It can step out here and reach a lot farther. Maybe something I can do here to help you guys see that. We'll turn this mare here. And maybe I'll do this. Instead of two track, maybe I'll ask her to do a little bit more of a side pass. So just watch here as I ask this mare to move over. Watch what those feet are doing. Now this right here is exactly why I didn't warm her up this morning. You guys are gonna watch this mare fight me in my hands a little bit. But again, that's something that we need to address with your horses at home. Now I'm gonna show you what that looks like from that end so we can focus more on the hind feet. If I ask this mare, and I'll let her move off at a diagonal a little bit. So you can kind of see she's pushing into my hands right there. Now I'm asking for a lot more lateral move right there, guys, but I'm only at a walk, okay? And as I'm doing that at a walk, but I'm asking for a little bit more of a lateral move, and I'm asking her to give me 3 or 4 or 5, maybe 6 steps in a row. Now all of a sudden she's pushing into my hand. I'm at a walk. This is precisely why I'm saying we have got to slow this down, guys, and give these horses plenty of time, because if I already feel her pushing into my hand here at a walk, then when I pick it up to a trot, it's going to be even more. And when I try to pick it up to a lope, way more so than that. So I'm just playing around here. If my horse is really struggling to move them hips over, we started here on the fence talking about just moving them hindquarters over enough to where they're leaving a separate set of tracks than the front end, I might come over here and use this fence. I might need the fence on certain horses to help me get this side pass. See, there she's pushing through my hand enough that her head went up over the panel. This right here is a really good exercise for you guys. Because this emphasizes to the horse that they need to be thinking lateral and not just forward. So if my horse is stuck, not wanting to move that hip over, or maybe my horse, as soon as that horse starts to move that hip over, I feel my horse wanting to speed up, then I might just do this. I might just be asking for that, but my horse is trying to speed up right there. So I'll go ahead and bring him perpendicular to the fence, and I'll hold that and keep asking them to move off that leg until they come back down to the speed that I'm asking them to be at. If I'm just at a walk, to me right now, I just want to stay at the walk, and I just want to start moving that hip over. And anytime I feel this mare wanting to speed up, I'm asking myself, what could I do right here that would help remind this mare, yes, down the road we are going to be speeding up, but I don't want you to get in a hurry. I need you to think it's more lateral. Because what's going to hurt me down the road when I try to take this lead departure and then move into a lead change, if my horse isn't willing to move that hip lateral, then I'm really going to struggle. Now I'm going to move her up to a trot a little bit. I'll stay off the fence for a minute. Going here to the left. I'm going to tip her nose slightly to the left. And ask her to move off my left leg. Now right there, to me, I think she pretty much, to me, she felt like she moved her shoulder more than she did her hip. There she gave me a little bit more of her hip. That felt pretty nice right there. Now think about this. When my horse is crossing their hind feet, when she's thinking about moving lateral with her hind end, and she's crossing her hind feet, that takes away the forward drive. Okay, so how do I ever get to a point where me moving this lateral leads me to a lead departure? Because I've actually got to gain speed to get to the lope, but yet I'm moving this lateral, and at times I might be moving it lateral so far that I'm taking all the forward away from her. So I have to be aware of that as I'm playing around out here. To me, I kind of use it to my advantage. Okay, if I've got a horse that I'm struggling to get him to go at all while I'm moving the hip, then maybe I don't move the hip that much. Because if I move it very far, he's already struggling to maintain his forward at a walk. And if I move it very far, I've just killed that. So I'm just gonna move it a little in the beginning to where he understands I don't wanna lose my forward. I've got that horse that when I go to move that hip over, I get all this extra speed because that horse in his mind is just trying to gain speed off the squeeze from my leg, thinking that it feels pretty similar to when I squeeze with both. Then on that horse, I'm probably gonna move his hip so far that it takes some of that forward away from him, just so I don't have to fight him so much. I'm still gonna be reminding him in my hands that, hey, I don't want you to pull on me. And I'm even gonna be so specific as to help this horse find a specific frame that I want him to eventually be able to hold that frame while I ask for this lead departure. You know, if I was just gonna come out here and use my reins and adjust where his head is just to focus on this and I didn't care what frame he would be in, it'd be a whole lot easier. But if I'm gonna be particular enough to think about, could my horse stay in somewhat of that frame where I could drive his hip up underneath him and keep his back round, and he learned to drive off with his hip, then I'm gonna have to take my time, guys, because right here's where my horse is gonna fight me the most. And if I'm trying to drive this hip up underneath him and get him to move it over, but yet he feels me up here just trying to hold him back, it's understandable if my horse would get nervous or get frustrated or even get mad at me. And a lot of times, I haven't really got there yet because I haven't done a lot of this on this mare yet, but I'm sure I will. There'll be times where I'll be out here playing around and ask that hip to move over and I'm focused on the frame she's in and she gets a little bit tight and she makes the change or she moves her hip over, and then when she does, I reward her for it and I set my hand down and now she's just a little bit mad and there she goes. Now all of a sudden I got all this extra speed that I didn't ask for. And where'd it come from? It come from the frame of mind that my horse just developed, because it's me forcing them into it and not really giving them the time to work at it. I expect my horse to get, this is a tough deal. And a lot of people don't even go there because of what it brings out in your horse mentally. But if you'll just stay slow and have a concept of, well, if I move the hip too far, he can't get any forward. If I move it just enough, then, or just a little bit, then he's still running off. What am I after when I'm trying to get my horse to think about move the hip? The number one thing I'm after, guys, is I want my horse to stay quiet. So as much as I have to play with it at a slower speed, I don't care if it's 5 days or 3 months, it'd be worth it to you in the end. I'm gonna go warm myself up one more time, give this mare a break. She's pretty hot, as you can see. But when we come back, I'm gonna work through all this stuff and I'll pick it up to a trot and let you guys see the places where she's gonna struggle. She's gonna struggle getting off my leg. She's gonna struggle wanting to go faster. She's gonna struggle trying to come out of my hand. So I'll let you guys see all that at a trot. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.
Riding horses each day is a horse lover's dream.
We've been riding CSI saddle pads for close to 12 years. This custom pad was made for us in 2005, and with probably close to 10,000 hours of use on it, you can clearly see how well they hold up. With their flex plate designed to disperse uneven saddle pressure and their interchangeable Velcro system, these saddle pads will fit any horse and offer superb protection. So if you're serious about keeping your horse sound and comfortable, you need to let CSI saddle pads have your horse's back. The Kerry Kuhn training halter is designed to eliminate the rolling effect from a lateral pull to help keep your halter in place at all times. With sliding rings to ride with, it works with the rider to pinpoint pressure where it will help the most. All right, guys, let's get this mare trotting around here and play around with this concept of just trying to start to build some control with this hip where I could move it over to eventually start to ask for a specific lead departure. Again, it's pretty chilly out here this morning. We didn't warm this mare up because I wanted this mare to show you guys when she's a little bit fresh. She's traveling around out here like we've loped her for 4 hours, but she'll liven up here in a minute. But she's gonna lean and pull in my hand some here with her still being fresh. So I'm gonna slip over here to the fence. And as I'm traveling down the fence here, I'm just gonna tip her nose to the fence. Ask that hip to move over and just trot off. I'll come off the fence. I'm just going to circle back around and come back to it. So I'm tipping the nose to the fence. Moving that hip over here. I'm going to do it again. You saw a little bit more life show up right there. All I did was reminder through this dressage whip what my leg was asking for. I felt like she could have got off my leg a little bit more. So now we've taken that two track and now we're just trotting her around asking for the same thing. Now if I was to set this up and I come over here and I ask her to move that hip over, and right there she's trying to speed up and I'm not asking her to speed up, I might go ahead and move that hip so far I get her perpendicular to the fence, which would cause her to come back to a walk and then tip her nose back there to the left and come out of that at a walk. So the timing of my release, I got to think of it this way. When I squeeze with 1 foot in position 3 right in front of my back cinch, I want my horse thinking move over. I don't want him thinking speed up. Eventually, when I'm ready for this horse to get up to the lope, then what I like to do for my cue to get to the lope is I'll smooch him up to the lope. I don't want him thinking just get up to the lope off my leg. I want him thinking move over off my leg. Down the road when they hear that smooch, then they can flow on up to the lope. But for now, so there's going to be a lot of time here, guys. Get back to the trot here. Just circle back here and do it the other way. Time or two. To me, this mare feels like it's a lot easier from a trot to move her hip off my left leg. Now I mentioned that my left leg over here is gonna be back here in position 3. I'm gonna move her to right there so the camera can see my right leg. My right leg is gonna come out and I'm gonna move it forward. Okay, so my inside leg, I'm moving the hip to the right. So my right leg to me is my inside leg. That leg's not only gonna come off my horse, but I'm gonna move it forward. Okay, my left leg's gonna come back and it's gonna come in. Okay, eventually I want my horse to kind of play off this as well. I wanna make sure I open that side up. But if I think about my lead and my horse's hip moving right or left, and my horse moving like this some, it's almost like I'm doing that with my body here, and I'm just asking my horse to feel that and do the same thing. So here as I go to the left, yes, I'm squeezing with my right leg back here in position three, but my left leg's gonna come off that horse's side and move forward, not just to give the horse room to move the hip over there, but also to turn my bottom half of my body to where my horse can feel me twist right there and be thinking about making that same move to stay with me. Come back to a trot. And I'm gonna do a couple where I'm gonna come in here to the fence, move her off my leg, and I'm gonna bring her down to a walk as I do it. Then we'll go back this way to trot. Move her off my leg, I'm gonna bring her down to a walk. Then I'll just leave her alone and walk out of it. When I make that transition from the trot down to a walk, all I'm doing is I'm reminding this horse that this is not a move right here where I'm trying to get you to think about speeding up. This is a move that I'm trying to get you to think about moving over, moving that hip over there. So if I could, in the beginning, just as I'm trying to build some control, if I'm sitting on that horse that maybe somebody's tried to do some lead changes with that really struggles moving that hip over without gaining some speed, all they want to do is really, really speed up right there, then I'm going to practice this a lot, where I'm going to come into it at a trot, move her off my leg, come down to a walk. Now notice this, guys. As I tip her nose into the fence, for this to lead me into a lead departure, she's got to keep going that way. So if I take her so far that I get her perpendicular to the fence, and I might even do it, I mean, if all she's wanting to do is run off right there, while I'm pushing that hip over and I get her perpendicular to the fence, I was headed this way. So I'm always gonna finish coming out of it that way. Now I might go ahead and circle right back around here and go back and do the other side. But I gotta get this mare where she understands that it's not just a lateral move. There's some forward involved too. What I do with the forward, it's just in conjunction with what my horse is throwing back at me. If my horse, like I've been saying, wants to continue to just gain speed, so there she's at a lope, I'm gonna go ahead and bring her all the way back to a walk as I'm moving that hip over. Great example right there. I didn't necessarily ask her to lope off, but it gave me that chance right there to show you guys how I might hold that and bring her back to a walk. And she was even fighting my hands a little bit where she was coming up with her head, trying to come, maybe I'd say try to come out of that bridle a little bit. To me, that's as important as what I'm trying to get done with the hip. So I'm gonna play around with this as slow as I need to. Tell you what, just for the fun of it, I'm gonna set that up again, but I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna come on off the fence, come past where that breeze is getting me. I'm gonna lope her off right here. And then when I come over here to the fence, I'm gonna start pushing that hip. Bring her down to a walk and then flow out of it just like that. Now, It's all relative to what I'm going to practice the most, guys, off the horse that I'm sitting on. Okay? That's something to me that I'm going to do a lot of if I'm sitting on that horse that has the tendency, when I'm pushing back here in position three, to move that hip over. That horse has a tendency to want to speed up. Then I'm going to practice what I just did over there from the lope down to the walk a ton. But if I'm on that horse that I'm struggling to get any forward at all, to me that exercise might hurt me a little bit, okay? We're just gonna have to try to judge the horse that we're sitting on. Let's try that once going this way. So here I am at a lope. I'm gonna push that hip over. And I'm going to bring her down to a walk. Very nice. She felt really, really good off my leg right there. I didn't have to help with my dressage whip. Now she changed where her head was a little bit. She wasn't really leaning on me in my hands, but she was trying to come out of frame just a little bit. But again, I'm gonna expect that in the beginning, okay? As they're trying to figure out how to move this sideways and continue to go forward, I've gotta allow a little bit of wiggle room up here with their head and not just beat them up for it. Down the road, we'll be a lot more specific with that. But the cool thing about taking this approach where I'm just gonna slow it down and just keep it simple and try to figure out, is my horse wanting to speed up when I try to move the hip over? Am I killing all my forward? Through that repetition and letting my horse build some comfort and some confidence in what I'm doing, what I'll notice is all the fighting that they do up here with their head starts to go away as my horse is getting better, and I'm really not having to focus that much about where my horse's head is or what I feel them doing from their withers forward while I ask for that. So if you guys are thinking about what you're trying to get accomplished in your horse, this mare, I think, this mare's fun because she wants to carry some life, so I don't have to work really hard to get it. But this mare also, I've been around her long enough now to know that it wouldn't take much to get this mare mad. Okay, so if I'm gonna build confidence, and we're starting the introduction to a lead departure, but in all honesty, we're leading ourselves into a lead change, a flying lead change. But it all hinges to me on the frame of mind I build in my lead departure. And if I'm not going to go at it in a manner that's going to let this mare build some confidence versus getting nervous because I'm just trying to push her through it, this mare would be hard to get along with through this whole thing. I think this, to me, is probably one of the, physically, it's one of the easier maneuvers for a horse to do. If you turn a horse loose out in the pasture, you might watch them make 15 lead changes as they run across the pasture with their buddies. Now, of course, their heads up, and their backs are hollow, and they're doing it their way. They don't struggle with it. To me, what's hard about the lead change, which is built in my mind from a lead departure, is the mental aspect of it. And that, to me, is what I'm trying to make sure you guys understand today. It's not something we need to force on our horses. I'm talking just a little bit of moving that hip, and over time, maybe I can move it a little bit more. Over time, that horse get where she can move it over a little bit and trot off. She's just got to figure out how all that works. My question is, am I willing to go at it in a manner that's going to let her stay confident and comfortable while I'm doing it? I'll take one more short break. You guys don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Riding horses each day is a horse lover's dream.
Hi, I'm Kerry Kuhn. If you own horses, you're familiar with fly problems. Shoe fly leggings are the best fly protection you'll find because they protect the most valuable part of your horse, their legs. Their simple and easy to use design helps to reduce stress on the joints, muscles, and tendons by preventing painful fly bites on the lower legs, which keeps your horse from standing around stomping all day. Made from a flexible plastic mesh, they do not restrict blood flow or range of motion and allow plenty of air circulation. So if you're looking for fly protection that has your horse's health in mind, shoe fly leggings is your best answer. Our horses wear them, you'll want your horses to wear them too. So check out your local feed or tack store, or for more information, go to shoeflyleggings.com. Our horsemanship company keeps us out on the road all year long. We can't afford to be broke down along the highway with a trailer load of horses. Nothing keeps our trucks running better and saves us money with less frequent oil changes than BG oil products. Find your nearest BG oil product dealer today so you can enjoy the BG advantage. All right, guys, I want to thank you guys for tuning in this week. Again, just keeping it simple this week for you guys at home, just trying to give you the idea. Primarily, yeah, we're talking about moving the hip over, but I think I've talked more today about my horse's frame of mind than anything. I'm not interested in whether or not this mare will move her hip over if she gets so tight and nervous that she can't hardly contain herself while she does it. To me, I'd rather you not even move your hip over, okay? My horses have got to learn how to do this and be relaxed while they do it, or it's not going to benefit either one of us. One more quick recap as far as my seat position. I try to think about staying just centered on my horse, and primarily what I'm doing more than anything is if I'm asking my horse to move the hip to the right, this leg's coming back and it's going to squeeze in position three. This leg's not only coming out, but I'm going to move it forward. Okay, so it's almost like I'm twisting here a little bit. This back, this forward should help my horse figure out I want the hip to step over there. Okay, and vice versa to the left. This is coming back. My right leg is going forward. But primarily what I'm trying to do up here where I'm sitting on my horse's back, I'm primarily trying to stay squared on my horse and do the majority of it with my legs. Now this mare, I think this mare's gonna be a really nice loper. And I think that the lead change is gonna be something that's gonna be easy for this mare if I stay out of her way. But what I'm gonna have to work on the most, guys, is make sure that I take my time so I don't get this mare nervous and bothered and potentially mad and upset at me while I'm working at it. Now, if you guys are interested in seeing some more exercises that we work on a daily basis to kind of build the control that we're trying to establish with the hindquarters, you can go to kerrykuhn.com, log on to our Empower team, and see some more exercises there. So thanks again for tuning in this week. We'll be back next week talking about this a little bit more in depth. We'll speed things up a little bit and see what she looks like then. So thank y'all very much for tuning in.
Ride some horses, but remember they need a leader to trust in to help them succeed. Oh, let's ride some horses that look in their eye. So saddle me up and let's go for a ride.
Say goodbye to the folks, Patch. Good boy.